I am garbage. I'm hoping that I don't know if I'm a whoop stone or something. You do it be like that some days. I say, y'all don't know if I'm whoop that nigga. Some days it be. Matter of fact, I beat him the last 4 times in a row and then the nigga beat me the other day.
Oh, shit.
But I really wouldn't. I ain't gonna lie, son. Our real life was not nowhere near in my bed. When we played, I was fucking up a lot because I felt like he couldn't really fuck with me. And next thing you know, he had made the game close, and I couldn't fuck with him. But I just messaged you earlier.
Yeah, go ahead, man. I'm about to go ahead and eat. Go ahead and get on it.
I just sent you the link.
The link for what?
For the game.
Y'all put it in the post.
Oh, shit, I don't
know. I'll do it. Well,
shit,
I
think
Nazir and
them already playing. I sent it.
Why?
No. Stay on that phone, bitch. About to play the game you've been waiting for. About to play the game that niggas said was coming all season.
What, Green Bay?
Me and Ben in the NFC Championship in true.
Oh, you made it.
Huh?
I said you made it. I didn't even realize it was made.
Yeah. By the hardest, but you made it. So, I mean, it's on the tubes. Yeah, actually, it was a good game. I wasn't all the way in it, but I figured at some point, like, what he had going on, because it was, like, a lot of pass, and I was like, I'm going to catch him slipping and pick that shit off. Like, it was a lot of close passes. It wasn't like, you know how niggas be running wide open, and you like, damn, I can't be here and there. Yeah.
Okay,
get on. What's up, Gully? I'm about to try to play Ben. You know, Ben don't talk to me no more while we play. I don't know why he ever did. Me? It don't matter if I talk to you or not. I don't give a fuck. Even though I'm still so talented that bitch talking about a game a while, babe. You remember that game with the Ravens?
For my money, it's the best then it's snowing out this motherfucker. Football time as postseason action descends upon FedEx Field just outside of D.C. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl. And we've got a classic
coach duel look ridiculous. I mean, not coach, the Bengals football team. For the right to return here in 2 weeks for Super Bowl 56, we are underway in L.A. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25. They had hold you. At their own 25-yard line.
Hey, look.
He had a little razzle dazzle on offense.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Throwing is Wilson. Being chased out left. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
Man, I threw it to the wrong nigga just now, son. When I tell you I threw it to the wrong nigga, I threw it to the wrong nigga. I had a nigga wide open, son, and pressed the wrong fucking button. Going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Second and 10 now, Wilson.
Oh shit. But he cannot avoid the pressure. Oh, this is gonna be one of them tough ass games, guys. Damn, I forgot he got them niggas on the line. In there to get him, it's a loss of five. Oh Jesus. Right here. Not the start you're looking for. Yay. Incomplete pass, followed by a sack. And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline.
And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. From the gun, it's Wilson. And he took the contact.
God damn, the niggas in that bitch. Oh, had to reinvent the wheel.
For the defense there, they forced him to throw that one into coverage. And just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. 39 yards on the punt, just two on the return, and it will be Washington football now with a first and 10 at their own 40-yard line. A good starting spot for Washington as they come up first and 10 at the 40. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Alden Smith there on the tackle.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. So the shotgun snap to Allen. Allen hit. He lost the football.
I'm waiting on that crossing route. I jumped on that shit. He couldn't even throw that. Let's go.
And they bring this one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. Yeah. And on a stage of this magnitude, the conference championship, so many early game jitters can happen. So that scores a big relief to a coach.
Yeah, no one wants to mention that in the locker room before the game. No one says, hey, let's don't fumble or don't do this because you don't want negative thoughts. That's why getting off to a good start is so huge for everyone. The first score in a conference title game, massive.
I was on the nigga you were trying to throw that bitch to do, man.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Washington will take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They'll need to come from behind if they want to play in 2 weeks as they trail early in this NFC Championship game.
Superstar.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defense in front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play?
When that boy Pete White again, he's injured like that.
Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Mike, 56, right there, 56.
From the 24, Allen got a man. It's Gibson complete.
Kyle,
now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
Throwing is Allen on third. And looking for McLaurin.
Everywhere. How was everywhere just now?
Picked up by the linebacker Bobby Wagner. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
Oh, good question. They got a Wagner.
All week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
He's brought down by the cornerback William Jackson.
It's a pickup.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready. It looked for that run pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter.
Able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Third and long, it's Wilson. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Will Jackson with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player.
You're pretty decent at that, no
way. Trust with the ball, try to get things settled down a little bit.
Sometimes it would be shit.
The last run got a couple, here's 2nd and 8. To throw, it's Allen. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 19-yard line. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down. They'll try the left side. It's Gibson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
He was tackled.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high.
Oh,
and have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
1 yard line.
Sick of being shit already.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. Eluding the pressure right. And this one will be intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker Bobby Wagner. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. I know it appeared he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open. So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting that you are. In this case, he was not, and it turned into disaster for them.
Brings up second and
five. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. 23 yards the pickup there.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Take four, take four.
They'll run on first down. It's Carson. The safety, Landon Collins, there to make the tackle.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. Throwing on second and eight.
Shit. And he's going to go. Damn it, son.
He will be sacked on the final play.
Somebody won't block one of them niggas.
7-0 on EA Sports.
Washington, nothing.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a defensive perspective. They gave up a touchdown on the opening drive, and then after forcing a punt on their last possession, it looks like they're going to get the football back again.
Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. It'll be called just a 22-yard punt, certainly not what he wanted. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
They turned the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. After the loss to start out,
here
it's
second
and 11.
Huh? How about that for us? You didn't?
To the air.
I thought we had got jumped on it. No, we're going to make sure they're eliminated.
This is good for a first down. Right. His second grab of this NFC Championship bout.
And this was a nice example of an offensive scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Here's Allen on first and 10. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Second and five at the 42-yard line.
They'll try the left side. Gibson. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
He is playing good run defense,
Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Play action. Now it's Allen. And the throw there going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
What a word.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it,
hugging
it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big
Another start benches.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth.
56 to Mike, boy. 56. Check 56. Rabbit, rabbit. Rabbit, rabbit. 56.
Okay.
They do go for it. Here's Allen.
Okay.
Find Hall.
Not when I was out, I was right in the, about
the
fence.
Inside the 45.
Come on, y'all can't push right now.
14 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive. On first down, it's Gibson. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down.
That's another Washington first down.
From the gun, it's Allen taking a shot for Samuel. And this is taken in for a Washington touchdown. Curtis Samuel, 30 yards. And Washington now an extra point away from tying this thing up. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes the defense is tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
Their own 23-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
God damn, son. Will you lock your man? Could it?
Second and manageable. Keep accumulating that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Say that. I just need you to hold him for a second.
Second and 10. Operating from the gun. Wilson. That's complete to the tight end.
That's a face mask.
And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. From the gun, Wilson. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete.
Yes, man. Damn bitches is.
Back at the 35. Despite the completion,
man.
They're going to wind up losing three there.
Somebody help me, nigga.
They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
The Seahawks on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's third and 2. Here's Carson, and he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and it'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And the Seahawks.
2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. A reminder, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report in a bit. The coach is with us per usual as we start to look ahead, Charles, to our potential matchups in this year's Super Bowl.
Break it down, coach.
Girl, why the fuck do you flick up? Oh, man, these niggas blowing this one.
Will Disley, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
All you had to do was flick the fuck up, son. Nigga playing his own. He'll stupid ass hit down.
Throwing again. Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big. Okay. But in the end, give some credit to the defense. Finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Oh, open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Wilson to Metcalf that time. First down, Seattle. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. They'll run on first down. It's Carson. And a short gain down to about the 33. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Second and eight. From the gun, Wilson. This one into the hands of Metcalf. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two. Operating from the gun, Wilson dancing.
Wrong button.
Left.
Ah, fuck, I pressed the wrong button.
The coverage, too
good. I pressed the wrong fucking button, Ellie.
Drop the ball free and it's fourth down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Oh, fucking butt.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and two. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Pete Carroll, no stranger to rolling the dice. He'll roll it again. Fourth down, they're going for it.
I'm coming after you. 26 left, 26 left, left.
They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. No one. He's going to go down. Back at about the 37 yard line. Chase Young. And Washington will have another turnover on downs.
Somebody blocked this nigga. And I seen the nigga I was supposed to drive.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time. A drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Close the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Given 14 on the play, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs. Shot before half for Allen, escaping the pressure right, and this will be incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship, as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Michael Dixon to kick off for Seattle.
The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. That'll be taken about a yard deep, and we will not see a return to start the half, as this will be a touchback. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn, as they've got it first and 10.
Check 24, check 24. Check the backer, check the backer.
Now Allen. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Throwing on first down is Allen. Winds up and lets it go for... It's caught inside the 25. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A huge play there for Washington. 45 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back.
That was all my fault. Touchdown. Yeah, the wrong fucking person from somebody else.
Taking it in from the 20, and Washington has taken the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block it all downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
You're fucking deep. All right,
need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Them the bitches.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Seahawks take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go
with... Fuck, son. I just need a little time. Hey, guys, damn.
Chase Young, make that
now. These niggas did not block this one.
Tonight's ball game. Second down. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, that's complete into the hands of Carson. Wilson's and he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Might be right. I might have a damn little shit on that drive.
How tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game.
Tyler Lockett. He's got Lockett. And all the
got him. Got him. Got him.
Tyler Lockett, 76 yards, and the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-ground?
I missed the fucking extra point.
Especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
How the throw, the catch,
and the fucking extra point
to get it to the end zone.
Michael Dixon to kick off for
Seattle. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone, and he'll decide to not bring the...
Right. Ridiculous. See, this fucking doozy. Mix with this, got a little cigarette, got life break. What game doing, man? What game doing, man? Nigga ready to play. I know, could have called a nigga, told him he had to pause the game for a long time or something. Yeah. Hey, man. I think we're in the middle of a playoff game, but they just scored, dude. Yeah, and that's what I mean, like, you gotta think about it, son. Like, me and Ben used to play games against each other, but then recently we got in the same division, played in the playoffs, played the Packers. Like, we just didn't play a lot of games recently against each other. There's only so much more you're gonna do. But that was part of it right there. That was part of it right there. Yeah, like, I already know kind of what he thinking, so I'm like, okay, he think that this, nope, I'm gonna stretch that bitch out. I just always said I needed the time. I ain't got the time for a nigga to get down the field. Hey. Oh, yeah, Everett. Huh?
I was in the dog outside. I'm with my brother. I'm on. I'm ready.
All right.
Their drive will begin at the 25.
Who was winning the other game? The Bengals.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
2nd and 3 at the 32-yard line.
They'll keep it on the ground. Gibson, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays.
But
I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker. Let's make these babies cry all the way
back. On first down, it's Gibson. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37.
He's brought down.
Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Brings up 2nd and 9.
And now they'll throw with Allen. Throw to the right here, taken in by McClure. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
46-yard line.
Throwing now is Allen. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards the pickup, first down Washington. So from Seahawk territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line. They'll try the left side. Gibson. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8.
95, Mike. What's 95? On Yardley.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. Catch here, left side, Thomas. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
At the 27-yard line.
Throw. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington.
They hit me over the top.
His 2nd touchdown of the night. And Washington going to add on to their lead.
In order to
lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
At their own 24-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Left side complete to Lockett. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
Now they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely, great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted.
What the fuck just happened? Oh, man. Go get I'll be fucked. What? What?
They'll take over first and 10.
My man did a possession catch, dropped that motherfucker into Benham.
This offense thankful, I'm sure, to have the football back, but also, Charles, after a long drive of their own, they've got to be a little weary.
Yeah, I would agree with that, and what you have to do to combat it, try and get fresh legs in where you can, especially the skill positions. And then for the offensive line, instead of attacking, maybe slow the tempo down a little bit. Let them catch their breath.
He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas.
No, he's just home. I'm like, what the fuck is that?
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. He was trying to clear the way, the big fullback. Instead, he gets a hold.
And you don't see that very often on running plays from those guys, because usually they're the lead blocker. Normally, when he gets caught, it's in a passing situation.
For the right to go on to the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
The way this shit go, I ain't gonna want to win this shit.
On second down now, it's Gibson. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Throwing is Allen on third. Slings this deep for McLaurin. And this is caught inside the five. And he is into the end zone.
I did not think that nigga was going to get it.
Terry McLaurin. 53 yards.
And like, I was running with him, and I really didn't think that he was about to, you know, throw it. So I played though, and then he picked
it. Another one through to extend the lead.
Seahawks 13.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
You just beat your day down the game. Son.
This one fielded at the five. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
First and 10.
At their own 28 yard line. I hate the
coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And their dream of a Super Bowl brought it so close three quarters ago, but rush coming and he's taken down. Chase Young. My goodness, make that now five sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance.
You know, it don't feel good.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and abundant.
Another try after the first down sack.
God damn, that nigga just
intercepted a third time.
It was also a little pick on an easy play. Nigga wouldn't even write that. I don't even know how that nigga jumped in front of my man.
Hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown.
That nigga was in a zone, nigga.
Closed, locked, reinforced.
The point after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good. And the lead opens up now to 22 points.
Man, that nigga was open enough to where Russell was supposed to hit him with. But,
this one fielded at the 5. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
At their own 28-yard line.
Oh, that is very nice.
Here to begin their next drive.
The wall is on
the
right.
Offense. And that last pick 6 may have been the backbreaker as they now face a 3-score deficit in the fourth quarter. They need points quickly. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Wilson, out to his left. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Landon Collins. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
Nigga, Russell, throw that business in.
This defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They're coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Going to give this time to the tailback. And gets by him in open daylight. And he gets this one just shy of the 40 down at the 39. This drive starting off
with game man, say, boy, fuck you.
This defense, Charles, they have unraveled here in the fourth.
In a sense, it's like they're being pressed like in a basketball game, and they just can't get the ball over half court. I mean, no matter what they do, they can't get off the field, they can't slow them down, they're just going up and down the field against them.
See, I ain't gonna lie, it was a good play game by him, but man, it's fucking me.
With a second and 3.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up. Gibson gets hit and he fumbles it. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
I don't care what the scoreboard says, partner. You know who's winning this game right now?
Mother Nature?
Yes, indeed. Precipitation's winning in a big way. Sloppy, sloppy. All these turnovers right now.
Yeah, well, this was the forecast. We got what was forecasted, and we've gotten a lot of turnovers. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going
to
run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time? Hopefully with a chance to win.
Now a man open down the middle of the field, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or...
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That one good for 14 in the Seahawks first. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Not much there, only a yard. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation. Get me a...
He's going to be sacked back in the 23-yard line.
That's what this makes.
Montez Sweat, his 2nd sack.
This line looks good sometimes.
Defensive coach always say, guys, is, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead.
I really know.
They've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
Flush. All right, damn, nigga's pass is a motherfucker. Right. Damn, nigga, shit.
So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Looking for the end zone. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. The Seahawks go for it but can't convert. And Washington will have it on the turnover on downs. They'll run on first down. Gibson. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Brings
up an interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
That's good. It's a pickup of six.
Brendan, every great running backs coach that I've talked with has always talked about when you have great vision, you're not consciously thinking about your cuts and your moves. You're just doing them. And I think that's what we're seeing tonight. He's about running them into submission.
You took the words right out of my mouth. I was just going to use that phrase. He has run them into submission.
Wave the white flag.
It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11.
At the 49-yard line.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. And a pivot here to his running back. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
At their 49-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
Cody Barton.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Now a handoff here to his running back.
In this bullshit.
And more inside the 40. 20. And he's going to take this all the way down to the Seahawks 15.
That nigga about to make another one. It's a big fucking play.
Drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first down.